Subscribe to Techo on YouTube or you will forever be a bot at Fortnite.
What's going on, guys, and welcome back to another video. With the increasing skill gap in Fortnite, aim is becoming more and more important in game, and of course a major part of that comes from your sensitivity. So with that in mind, in today's video we're going to be discussing how you can find the best sensitivity in Fortnite Chapter 2 Season 6. If you want to enjoy this video, be sure to drop a like on it, subscribe if you're new and want to see more. And lastly, before we get into it, I want to give a shout out to the sponsor of today's video, which is Buff. Buff is an incredible program for PC that allows you to literally make money by sitting there and playing games. You can earn gift cards for a bunch of things like Nintendo, Steam, PlayStation, and even brand new keyboards and mice, all by simply playing Fortnite. What Buff does is essentially run in the background of your game, collecting data on your in-game performance and achievements. The app is incredibly easy to use. All you've got to do is let it run in the background and you'll make money doing it. Best of all, there are no noticeable performance decreases, so you can simply play the game like you usually would. With that said, guys, I'm going to be putting a link to Buff at the top of the description. I absolutely recommend you give it a shot, as it's essentially free money. With that said though, thank you once again Buff for sponsoring this video, and without further ado, let's get into it. So the first question that a lot of players have in pretty much any season is the big question between high or low sensitivity. Should you use a high sensitivity to emphasize quick builds and edits, or should you use a lower sensitivity to focus on having insane aim while potentially causing some small issues with your mechanics? And as with any setting, this is really going to be a lot of preference, but I personally recommend using a low to medium sensitivity. The main reason that I recommend lower to medium sensitivity is because aim is such a major skill gap, and being able to hit those shots consistently is easily one of the best ways to win more fights in game. As well as that, you can still have extremely strong mechanics as long as your sensitivity isn't ridiculously low, which is why I just find this to be the best option for most players. Once again though, it does come down to preference, but as I said, my personal recommendation is to try lower to medium, and you can feel free to experiment a bit and see what you like best. Another really quick tip I have when it comes to sensitivity is just to make sure you're also adjusting it to your setup. For example, some of you guys might have cheaper, sort of less responsive mice, which would mean a lower sensitivity might be harder to play on. Some of you might have really large or really small mouse pads. Just try to keep in mind that there's a lot of factors at play, and your setup might have certain aspects that cater better to a higher or lower sensitivity. Of course, you always have the option to make changes to your setup or upgrade, but to avoid spending a bunch of money, I recommend that you just keep your own setup in mind while you're considering what sensitivity to choose. Next up in this video though, now that we've discussed some of the more basic stuff that I wanted to get out of the way, we're going to discuss the best ways to actually find and choose a sensitivity, as that's probably what a lot of you guys are waiting for right now. So when it comes to actually finding your sensitivity, the most common method that I usually see people doing is the trial and error method. This method of finding a sensitivity is probably the easiest way to do it, and really just consists of trying a bunch of different sensitivities out and seeing how they feel. Starting on one sensitivity, you just hop into creative, try the sensitivity out, and adjust it based on how you feel, rinse and repeat until you feel like you found the right one. Another method is the perfect sensitivity approximation method, or the PSA method, which is a pretty popular method since it's a lot more precise and takes more of the guessing out of the process. Essentially, how the PSA method works is you choose a starting sensitivity, plug it into a PSA method calculator, and from there you can choose if you want to make it lower or higher, rinse and repeat, and then the calculator will continue narrowing it down. Then eventually it's going to find what's considered to be the perfect sensitivity, essentially what you narrow it down to with your higher or lower choices. If you want to try out the PSA method, which is one that I highly recommend doing, I'll be linking a PSA method calculator down in the description, or you can simply Google PSA method calculator and find it fairly quickly. The last general method to find a sensitivity in Fortnite is one that I don't really prefer personally, but one that may work for some of you, and that's simply trying sensitivities from pros. Essentially, what a lot of players do is find a pro player who has a gameplay style similar to what they want to have, and then try their sensitivity out. This strategy is a bit rough around the edges since a pro player sensitivity isn't necessarily going to fit you, but it definitely is worth considering if you're having trouble with the other methods and just want to keep things super simple. As well as that, you can also just use a pro player sensitivity as a sort of starting point for the PSA method or the trial and error method, basically starting with a pro sensitivity and adjusting it as you see fit. Finally guys, once you do go ahead and find yourself a good sensitivity, the next step is to just focus on mastering it as much as possible. Once you decide on your sensitivity, my top recommendation mission is to grind out a bunch of aim duels, maybe some other in-game aim trainers, and try to really just nail down your aim as much as you possibly can before you start trying arena or any really serious game mode. Once your aim is at least pretty good and you feel confident with it, then I recommend hopping into some mechanics maps and grinding those out, and then finally heading into real games with a new sensitivity. It's going to be a process to master a new sensitivity, but with enough consistent practice, it really should not be too difficult to learn a new sensitivity fairly quick. With that said, everyone, that's going to wrap it up for today's video on how you can find the best sensitivity on keyboard and mouse. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to drop a like on it and subscribe as well if you want to see more content just like this in the future. And once again, guys, if you want to make some easy money by literally playing Fortnite, be sure to check out Buff, which is going to be linked near the top of the description. Thank you all for watching this video, though, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye for now.